Honorable Deputy Chief Minister of Manipur, who also happens to be the Science and Technology Minister of Manipur, all my distinguished scientist friends sitting on the dais, very senior directors and teachers from Northeast. I wish I could name all of them, but there are too many. And dear students and friends from the media. Well, we are extremely grateful to the Deputy Chief Minister also, because it's like a bonus for us. We got his presence here. And he was with me in the morning also. We had a meeting of Science and Technology Councils, and he was one of the few who at this level also represented the government in that meeting. Not many of you may know that he himself has a physics background. He is a graduate and a postgraduate in physics, and I had the privilege of hearing his worthy views in the morning at the Science and Technology Council meeting. So thank you, sir, once again, and I'm sure the students must be feeling more happy to see you here rather than me. And my very, very hearty welcome to all the dear students from all the sister states and Sikkim. So I'm feeling so happy, it's really beyond my expression or vocabularies to describe the delight or the pleasure that I enjoy seeing all of you, all the beautiful young children from Northeast. I'm sure that it's not an easy task to travel from Northeastern states to Lucknow. That's why I mentioned when I delivered that inaugural address that it's really heartening to see the enthusiasm of children. And I could see, you know, the first day after having traveled for I think more than 24 hours or so. It's a long journey. Even when we also go to Northeast, we find it's quite cumbersome. But thanks to Shri Narendra Modi ji, from 2014 to 2018, whether it is on the road or whether it is through the rail or whether it is through the connection within Northeast and connection of Northeast with India as far as transport facilities concerned, as far as our commuting from one place to other is concerned, it will become much more easier. So thank you so much for making this India International 2018 so successful and also glamorous because of the presence of all these young children. And even after 2 days, which is the 3rd day, I don't see any child looking tired, any child without a smile on his face. Those who don't have a smile on their face, please show me your smile. Good. I have not come here to talk about science or bore you with science, but the very fact that you have traveled long distances and you are so you are still appearing so enthusiastic, it itself speaks volumes about your commitment for science. and how much you value the importance of science. And that is why you have come to this India International Science Festival. On behalf of my Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji, I want to convey his greetings to all of you, his good wishes to all of you, and his blessings to all of you. Before I was leaving for Lucknow, he specifically told me that please make sure that you convey my blessings to all the children of India and more particularly to the children of North East. Do you know the first thing that he told us when we became minister and when we had our first cabinet meeting? That was in 2014. He told and instructed every cabinet minister that you may do whatever in your ministries, like planning for the rest of the country, but your topmost priority has to be planning for the northeastern states. And in 5 years, on every front, you have to show to me perceptible and measurable difference in terms of progress. And there too, more particularly for the students and the youth of North East. And I feel so happy and satisfied that after 4 years, virtually on every front that we can think of, including of course education and science development, and of course various number of programs that have been developed through science in the Northeast, the government of Narendra Modi ji has a very, very satisfactory and worth emulating performance. And I think this has also been valued and endorsed by the people of North East in the last 4 years itself, when the people in North East, means your parents, they have reciprocated the concern that was like Narendra Modi ji's commitment for North East. He fulfilled in terms of the various programs that he got implemented in every field. And the people also blessed him. And from 2014 to 2018, almost in all the states in North East, almost all the states, we find a government or a system which is Narendra Modi ji's system, Narendra Modi ji's party, and which works in close coordination and cooperation with the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So this is, I think, good news for North East. Every minister is supposed to be in North East at least 2 times every year. Every month there have to be 2 ministers who will visit North East. And for me, it was a special blessing because till 2014, I had never had the privilege to visit any place in North East. It took almost 60 years for me to enjoy a visit to the North East. And my first visit was to Assam in 2014, which gave me a lot of great moments working with scientists and people in Assam. And then following that, I think every state in North East I visited, I find that it is probably the one of the most beautiful places on earth. Do you agree with me? You are not so enthusiastic about it? You don't like North East? But your clapping doesn't show me that. Uh, I can tell you, I like Northeast more than the rest of the country by now. So it's a great place. It's almost like heaven. Like huge biodiversity, huge greenery, huge forest, and pure air. So many things, and people are so good. I'm sure that this visit of yours to this science festival is also going to give us rich dividends for future, because you are our now science messengers for the Northeast. I don't see a single student sitting here as a single entity. Now you have to become the messengers for the science festival, for the growth of science in this country, to the Northeastern region. And I will appeal to all of you to spend your time in this festival with great dedication, sincerity. Don't waste even one single moment. Visit each and every place. That is not only that you have been called for this Northeast conclave. You have been called and invited to this function to see science from the closest possible quarters. And once you see that, I am sure that you will develop huge amount of passion for science. You will certainly be able to develop a dream for yourself to work with science and to become great people in life with great scientific acumen. And just for your knowledge, I have to tell you that even in science and technology, we have committed significant portion, almost 20-30% of the budget, say in biotechnology, which has to be spent only in the Northeastern region. That is a mandate. No, never has it happened. It's happening now. And that's where we find that, can you believe it, that there are 700 twinning programs. Twinning programs means there is an institution in the Northeast, there is an institution somewhere in anywhere in the country, in west part of the country. And the Science and Technology Ministry of the Government of India facilitates the coordination and the working together. So what is happening in west of India, it has to be transferred to the Northeastern country. And there are 700 training programs like this which are right now functional. There are almost today, when Dr. Aslam and I think mentioned about this big list program, the biotechnology labs that are being developed in the Northeast. Almost programs are 200 labs like this which have been developed in the Northeast or are in the process. And then there is a plan for future expansion also. Almost 126 biotechnology hubs have been developed. This is just a very brief account I am giving you, a lot of details of everything. And then 20 medical colleges with specialized medical diagnostic expenses have been supported by us. And then centers of excellence have been developed in various fields. So this is just about a very, very brief account of things that are happening in science, but on all other fronts, as I mentioned, whether it is transport sector, infrastructure sector, education sector, everywhere. So you should feel happy that we have a Prime Minister like Narendra Modi in the country, who has special attachment, special affection, and special feeling in his heart for the people of Northeastern states. And we are all working together to realize his dream. He has promised the country, he is working on a dream that he wants to deliver a new India to all Indians by the year 2022. And India, where every part of India is well developed. The areas in India which could not be developed to the extent that they should have been, we want to bring them to the level of the rest of the country. We want a smile on everybody's face. We want everybody in the green to be wiped out or eliminated or alleviated all the suffering. And he wants that every child, he should have good quality education, he should have good health, and he should have good quality nutrition, adequate amount of calories. And then he has number of schemes to help the women of the country, to help the girls of the country, to help the senior people of the country, and virtually every section of the society. So in this India International Science Festival, together all of us are also pledging that we will become a part of the dream of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. We will contribute a little bit definitely to helping him realize his new dream, because his dream is all about our prosperity, our happiness, and the growth of India, which is of course our country. So do you think that you all can become a part of his dream?
Yes.
Happily?
Yes.
Okay. So when you go back from here, apart from your studies and everything, please take a pledge that we will do something more than what we are routinely doing for the sake of our country and for the sake of the Prime Minister's dream. And apart from what you think, I want to give you a small idea. You know, they called me as Science and Technology Minister here, but I have come here as Environment Minister also. And as Environment Minister, we all feel, and the whole world is now worried about global warming and climate change. You are also worried about it, man? How many of the children know what is global warming and climate change? Raise your hands. Who knows a little bit? I am not going to ask you what it is, but please, honestly tell me. So that speaks volumes about the intelligence of the students of the Northeast. I must put my hands together to... But this is a very, very serious problem. And this is going to be a big threat for our Mother Earth in future. The whole world is worried about it, you all know. And all types of calamities happen in the country. Most of them are because of the ill effects of global warming and climate change. The most recent thing that we saw was what happened in Kerala. I hope all of you know how much Kerala suffered. 400 of our brothers and sisters, they lost their lives. Your young children lost their lives. 1 million people, they lost their homes. It was one of the biggest tragedies that we faced in recent times, and no particularly in Kerala. It is all manifestation of the ill effects of global warming and climate change that we could see in Kerala. I'm happy that a lot of young people, they went to Kerala to help those who have got affected. I heard that even young people from Northeast also went to Kerala to help their brothers and sisters. So I must congratulate you and compliment you for this great social awakening that you exhibited. As Environment Minister, one more thing. You must be aware that our Prime Minister got the highest award of the United Nations this year, only last week, for working very positively and very strongly for environmental issues, for global warming, for climate change. And He provided leadership at the international level also. He provided leadership within India also. And we in the Environment Ministry have, apart from many things, developed a sort of a social movement which can help us in the long run to deal with the issue of global warming and climate change and strengthen all aspects of environmental protection. Has anybody heard about the Green Good Deeds? Anybody in this audience? I can see a couple of hands. So Green Good Deeds is a movement that we have developed in the Environment Ministry, where we have put on record 700 small positive actions. Small positive actions that each one of us can perform every day. Be a part of them, make them a part of our lifestyle, make them a part of our habit, make them a part of our daily behavior. And these green good deeds, when performed, say each one, if we perform one, it means 1.32 billion green good deeds in one day in the country. Not a small number. And we have 700, list of 700. So what I am appealing to you today is, be assured, Government of India will make sure that there are best facilities for all of you in Northeast. They have started developing, and in coming years you will see much more than that. Study sincerely, take the best possible education, become good quality professionals, but also as a duty for our society, for our country, for your own state, and also for your younger brothers and sisters who are either not born or who will be born after 10, 15, 20 years in this country. So we have to see that today we do our best to protect our environment, to protect our biodiversity in Northeast, to help the cause of giving pure air to everybody, to have clean river, to have greenery all around, to have dense forests all around, to have compassion for nature, to have good quality relationship with wildlife. This is all about environment protection, all about respect to nature. So this is a list of green good deeds that I would like all Northeastern students to put them here. Take out one every day, perform. And when we will study these green good deeds, I am sure each one of you will say, I don't want to perform only one. Why are you saying only one? I can perform at least 10 every day. It is only about changing my attitude. It is only about changing my behavior. You will be able to do that. So if you promise me that you will perform a green good deed every day, I can tell you where do you get these green deeds from. Do you promise me? बहुत धीरे से बोलता है, कुछ मुझे मज़ा नहीं आया. आई डोंट थिंक आपको मन है ग्रीन गुड डीड करने का. आई डोंट थिंक यू आर रियली एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट इट. इफ यू आर एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट इट, यू कैन शाउट अबाउट इट एंड टेल मी दैट यू आर रियली एंथुजियास्टिक अबाउट द ग्रीन गुड डीड. इधर दीज पीपल आर लेस एंथुजियास्टिक एज कम्पेयर टू देम. Our Prime Minister says that he wants to provide every facility to every Indian in his or her telephone. That is why from 2014 to 2018, he has facilitated the laying down of 250,000 kilometers of optical fiber in this country. When I took oath as a minister, only 356 kilometers of optical fiber was laid down in this country. Now almost each and every panchayat in this country has
access to a to an optical fiber, and through that optical fiber there is virtually internet facility all over. So through the internet and through your phone you are connected to the whole world now so easily. So we have put an app in this phone which is named after the name of the Environment Minister of India, who is just now talking to you. His name is Dr. Harshvardhan. So will you remember his name? Are you sure? So if you write the name of the Environment Minister of India, Dr. Harshvardhan, in your phone's Apple Store or the Google Play Store, you get access to an app, and when you install that app in your phone and open it, the first thing that you see on the top is Green Good Deeds. And as soon as you click the Green Good Deeds, you get access to 700 positive actions, list of 700 positive actions that you can perform in your life every day, every year. And I'm sure that once you start doing it, you will get more and more blessings of God, because nature is another manifestation of God. Good environment, we have to ensure we give it to our future generations. This country will never forget the contribution of the young children in the eradication of polio from this country, because you all became polio sainiks starting 25 years back and ensured that till polio was wiped out from the country, every student was participating in the polio eradication movement. Today, if every child, every young person like you starts working for development of a social movement around Green Good Deeds, I am sure we'll be able to handle all the problems of environment, global warming, climate change, only by performing small positive actions. I don't want to get into those detailed positive actions, because that will mean another 1 hour of your... This music that you hear, this is the symbolic music. Somebody has downloaded the app. So when you do it in your phone, you will also hear the same music. So can I... So can I go back to my, you see, I wish to convey all my another music here. So that shows that the people in Northeast, and especially the younger people, are very smart, very receptive, very intelligent, and very truly human, truly concerned about our environment. And I am sure that if you will be able to do it, if you can't do it, nobody in this country will be able to do it. If the children will be able to do it, everybody will be able to do it, because you are the ones who will inspire your family, who will inspire your teachers, who will inspire your friends in school. And once you all start doing it, and fortunately we have so many respected teachers from the Northeast also who have accompanied you, they will, I think, ensure that you are all involved in this positive work. I once again thank all of you for a patient hearing, and assure you once again on behalf of my Prime Minister that we are always there to support you. Any one of you, I said something yesterday in the speech, any one of you, if you want to do something big, you have an idea and you want to become big by converting that idea into some entrepreneurship, something that you want to deliver for the country, for the society, for your family, the whole government stands rock solid behind you. We are there to support you, and the Science and Technology Department is behind you. You can be assured of that. With these few words, once again, thank you. And I wish that these 2 days conclave, where a lot of great things will be discussed, will certainly be something which you will not forget in your life, and it will certainly enhance the quality of life that you are enjoying. Thank you so much. Namaskar.